From financial freedom, improved fitness and mental health, people all want to become a better version of themselves. But the road to personal growth, they say, comes down to changing habits, trying new things, and to not be afraid of failing. But as always, it's easier said than done. Now here to help us navigate how we can achieve our goals for 2023, we're joined by multi-awarded global master coach and best-selling author Mike Celis. Good afternoon, Mike. Thanks for joining us.
Yeah, hi there. Good afternoon. I'm going live here from Hong Kong. I'm on vacation with my family.
Good
Happy
for
New
you.
Year, guys.
Good for you. Happy New Year in advance. Now, it is, Mike, that time of year, New Year's resolutions, and almost always very few people can sustain these resolutions throughout the year. Of course, there's a confluence of factors that may affect this, including, of course, personal circumstances, which may vary from one person to another, or even how realistic or far-fetched the goals are, and of course, discipline and proper planning. Now, of all of these, where do most people fail?
Mm-hmm. Okay, so it's really more of, you know, most people come up with their resolutions based on lip service alone, meaning
right.
It's just to go on with the bandwagon, meaning everyone's doing it, so I might as well come up with my own.
Mm-hmm.
However, what is very important here is that we take in consideration what is it that we really want in our lives,
mm-hmm.
and what is the main value of achieving that? Because once we anchor on our purpose, we are able to sustain it long after the new year is over. Remember, we can always choose to start all over again at any given point in our lives for as long as we commit to whatever it is that matters to us most.
All right, Mike, of course, as with any endeavor, the key to success is, of course, you mentioned earlier, proper visioning, knowing what you want in life, and perhaps a plan that is well put together. Unfortunately, this is not a skill that comes naturally to a lot of people. What simple tips can you offer to help people plan better?
Okay, first things first is to actually assess the space they're in. So you don't come up with a resolution for the sake of coming up with one, or just based on someone else's or what you think might work for you.
Mm-hmm.
It must be based on your current space. So meaning, where are you right now at this point in your life, and what do you need and want the most? It's all about acknowledging your personal truth as well. So meaning, what do you want to exactly achieve? And you have to be really specific about it.
Mm-hmm.
It's not just about, you know, say, I want to be
happy
here in 2023. How do you keep becoming here? Is it all about relationship? It's all about taking care of yourself better. So you have to be very specific about it so you can create mm-hmm. specific action plans that are related to it. However, do not overwhelm yourself with the action plans. Instead, focus on doing one little thing, one small thing at a time, and celebrating your progress along the way.
Mm-hmm.
Remember, achieving your goals does not mean achieving the end result itself.
Right.
It can also mean your everyday progress and how you celebrate it so that you get to honor yourself as well.
So it's really important that you can set up milestones for these goals, right?
Exactly. And also, please bear in mind, though, that even though there would be days that are, you know, that may seem slower than the others,
right,
or that may seem that nothing is happening, there is something happening there because it's teaching you virtues about patience, you know, being determined, and all those things that you take for granted along the way. It's not about, you know, again, the end goal. It's all about how you journey and how you enjoy it.
Of course, a lot of people would need help in that aspect from planning, visioning, and of course, setting those milestones and getting those goals done. Sometimes they need help from professionals like yourself, a global master, to help people set the course clearly. Tell us a bit about what you do as a global master coach. How different is this from a psychiatrist and perhaps from a motivational speaker, which is what we're quite used to?
Okay, so basically what I help my clients do is I help them overcome their limiting beliefs, gain clarity along the way so they can become their authentic, unapologetic, grandest versions of themselves, or in my words, their own hashtag best me ever. I help people get from their point A to point B. As opposed to being a psychiatrist or a psychologist, I don't normally deal with the past. However, I'm also trained in therapy and counseling, so there might be aspects of it that I might be talking about. And what I deal mostly with people is that I ask them powerful questions. That is one big differentiation from others who just offer advice. In my case, I let my coaches take responsibility for themselves by asking powerful questions that would lead them to gain clarity about what they really want and need in their current space. As opposed to motivational speakers, mine is grounded on a science. A science that is actually called coaching that has helped more than millions of people from all over the world who want to become the best versions of themselves, anchored on powerful questions.
All right, you speak so interestingly about your clients, the unicorns, if you will. You have a growing base of clientele. We're beginning to appreciate, of course, the importance of some structure and setting goals and pursuing goals in life. How has the industry changed in the last few years, Mike?
Well, the industry has become more open to coaching, and that is a very good thing for everyone, actually, because long before it has become big here in the Philippines, worldwide, it's already a $2 billion industry and growing. So most people are seeing the value of being coached, no matter what point they are in their lives. Contrary to popular belief, you don't just get a coach when you're depressed or when you're at your lowest point. You can be very successful and still have a coach, because I believe that everyone needs a coach, because every one of us has, you know, his or her own issues every single day that we need clarity on. And with our biases alone, we cannot resolve those. So we need someone to actually help us gain the clarity that we need so that we can become the person that we're meant to be.
And I've been meaning to ask, Mike, is it affordable to get one?
Depends on who are you getting.
All right. I mean, is this something that, of course, ordinary working people can afford? I would understand this could entail some costs.
Okay, let me be candid about it, Stanley. The value that you put on your coaching and your personal growth is the value that you should be willing to spend for yourself. So it's not really about the cost of getting a coach. About you and how much value and how much you want to achieve a goal of yours.
Okay, now let's talk about the last 2 years. Now, it's been difficult given the pandemic, which put a lot of lives, plans, even activities on hold. What insights can you share about the challenges in the last 2 years and how these affected mental health and wellness in general?
Well, a lot of people have suffered from anxiety and depression in the last 2 years because, you know, when something unfamiliar happens, people tend to come from a space of worrying too much and thinking that their lives are over. But here we are right now, 2 years after, and we're still doing good, I believe. And we made it through. Now, it has changed. Before, we always put our mental health and wellness last. We always focus on the superficial things and we rarely invest on ourselves. But this time around, the designer clothes had to go, the cars had to go, real estate had to go. It was more investment on ourselves and our personal growth, because we realized the value of taking care of ourselves first so that we can take care of others as well.
All right, on that note, we thank you a lot for joining us today, Mr. Mike Celis, Global Master Coach. Happy New Year to you.
Thank you.
Thank you for the insight.
Happy New Year, Sandy.